Time to battle round three here. Playing against FF Freak himself, Brad Nelson, actually. So, I don't think this is that much of a keeper on the draw. Playing against what looked like blue-black control. And, because, yeah, I did watch the replay. And, yeah. If I don't draw blue, this hand sucks. And if I do, it's still really bleh. This, on the other hand, is much better. I mean, it is a one-lander, but it's got Preordain, and as long as he doesn't duress it. Which he didn't. I can hopefully hit a few lands. Probably not going explore into Jace on turn three since, he's got counter spells, but this should be pretty reasonable. Bottom ship. Alright. Gotta be good news. That was not exactly what I wanted to draw. And Preordain. Mana Leak's pretty important in this matchup, but I don't think I can keep a second 1/1. I only have two lands because all the Mana Leaks in the world aren't going to help me if I start missing land drops. And getting Duressed or Inquisitioned. Yep. He's likely to take, well, Explore or Mana Leak are the two only cards he can take because Bolt's obviously not a consideration. It's gonna depend on his hand what he takes here. I think taking Explore is probably fine. Not only does that not give me a chance to draw an extra card, it yeah. Well, he took Mana Leak because he's probably got a Jace that he wants to resolve. I'll let him resolve his Jace. All right. Well, at least now I can possibly resolve my Jace on my turn. And Jace Bellerin, and we're dead. Well, not actually dead, especially since if he minus ones it and I draw a mountain, I get to punish it. But yeah, I think that's the right call on his part. I don't have that many red sources, and yeah, I didn't draw one, so. Jace is Jace, otherwise, he just keeps drawing cards. Let's see if he has another Jace. It's possible that I could have not Jaced his Jace and just let him draw, because little Jace doesn't actually crush you like big Jace does. Yeah, that was actually probably better. At least that way I have outs. I can draw red, bolt his Jace, resolve mine. Though, let's be honest, like that wasn't gonna happen either. At this point, I'm pretty dead, since I've got three mulligans in my hand. I basically just have four lands versus his six spells. So it's gonna be tough. Seagate Oracle, alright, it's not that bad. And a land. Oh, well played, me. I'm gonna brainstorm here. I know I could plus two it and get out of range of Creeping Tar Pit, but if I brainstorm into red, then he can't do that either. Let's see. Bolt, Mana Leak, play Mountain. We're in it to win it. Looks like playing Jace last turn was brilliant. Now he knows I've got the bolt, so he can't Creeping Tar Pit it. I mean, he can resolve his own Jace if he really wants to, but hey, at least I got to brainstorm. Another reason brainstorming is a lot better, I think, because if I just plus tutored, he's very likely to have a Jace of his own, a big Jace at this point. Although last turn he didn't have four lands and a big Jace, he probably had to Seagate into the land, or just had a tap land anyway, so he just played it. So if I just, last turn Jace plus twos it, he probably just plays a Jace and then I'm back at square one. I'm sure my Jace is dying here. Yep. And yeah, I think bolting the Seagate's okay. Yeah. Draw the Mana Leak that I know is there. Play Misty Rainforest, pass the turn. Obviously gonna crack the Rainforest on my turn. But we're still in it, kind of. Yep, Seagate's fine. Bolting the Seagate seemed like it was fine. I'm probably not gonna bolt this one, but bolting the first one seems okay. Yeah, I guess I might as well Mana Leak it. There's no real harm there. Upkeep, go get a forest, and draw something sweet. Not quite. Gotta play it though, just because could draw an Inferno Titan or an Avenger, and I need the mana. Alright. Big Jace. Well, I don't have mana leak. And he's probably gonna plus two it because he's gonna assume I still have got a lightning bolt. Oh good, he put a card on top. Yeah, that's pretty bad for me. If I had to guess, I'd say I'm probably not drawing, you know, something awesome. Well, at least he has, now I can protect myself from further Jace plus two-ing. Guess bolting that Seagate didn't work out so well, huh? If I had double bolt, I could have actually killed the Jace. Though if I don't bolt Seagate and I'm just taking a bunch of hits, like, yeah, I guess maybe that doesn't matter. Who knows? I mean, I think I'm pretty dead here. He's got a Jace going, although I guess he's not actually playing anything. And I could still draw my own Jace, which would probably resolve, since he'd have to have double mana leak to stop it. He's debating using Tectonic Edge. Again, he decides not to. Something awesome. Well, is it time to edge now? No, it's time to draw forest. Alright, might as well keep that one under wraps. Now he's gonna edge. Okay. Not a big deal, I suppose. Alright, Jacing is a big deal. You know, there's 8 cards in my hand and I have 2, a lightning bolt and a land. So I think this is the part where I concede. I don't see a sequence of plays winning me this game. So I'm afraid I'm gonna end it prematurely. Yeah, that's not gonna do it. Alright. Well, let's see what we got in our sideboard for Mr. Nelson here. Do like Coalition Reigns, do not like Tome of Magnet. Acidic Slam's okay, but not awesome. Rune Blasters are good. I do like Mindbreak Traps the way this matchup plays out. This is a matchup I played a lot more of than the blue-white versus matchup. And when you draw go, having a hard counter is useful. And Lightning Bolt's pretty horrendous. The only good bolt target there is Creeping Tar Pit, but boarding in a bunch of land destruction, so you can actually just get it. Grave Titan's annoying, but you got Volition Reigns and Mindbreak Trap if they do happen to have that guy. If they have Frost Titan instead, well, I mean, you still have to counter it. Need to cut one more. Question of whether I want to cut the Acidic Slime or not. Yeah, I think that's fine.